Well, hello, my loves. So I am doing a little solo episode today because it has been in my own personal experience lately. I've been having some fears coming up. You know, every time we try to do something new, go deeper, break through to the next level, the first thing that comes up for us is fear. So I wanted to share something with you that I often share with my coaching clients or students that take my class. I have this class called Reinvent, and it's a 6-week live online workshop where we sort of reinvent ourselves and really call forth the ideal self that we want to create. And so whenever we're trying to break through to the next level, you know, we bring up a lot of fear. What comes up for us is fear because we have in our minds what's called the default mode network. And that's a collection of neurons that play out different kinds of modes and patterns of behavior. And whenever we're trying to break out of that, what ends up happening is our subconscious mind sort of kicks off to be like, hey, don't do that, right? And it comes up in the form of fear. So what I have in front of me, for those of you watching the YouTube version, is a fear setting instructions worksheet that I got from the Tim Ferriss TED Talk. And so I'm just going to walk you through it. And if you would like a copy of this worksheet, I will figure out how to get it to you. I'll put it in the show notes. I'll put it a link in the YouTube channel so that you can get a copy. And the purpose is to unravel the fears and find out what exactly you're afraid of and how to mitigate it. I highly recommend that you look up the Tim Ferriss TED Talk. Super easy to find. I think he calls it the fear setting. Why you should define your fears and study your goals. So step number one, define everything you fear about the idea of taking action. List out your most nightmarish scenarios, your doubts, and your what ifs. What's the worst case scenario? What might go wrong? Write it all down and don't hold back. This is your opportunity to just vent it all out. Number two is assess the impact of these worst case scenarios on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being minimal impact and 10 being permanently life altering. And step number three in column two, list ways you could reduce the likelihood of each of these worst case scenarios from happening. What actions could you take to make those scenarios less likely to come to fruition? Consider both big actions and small ones, right? And then step four in column three, list ways you could repair the damage. So if the worst case scenario happened, what actions could you take to repair the damage or get back on track? I've done this exercise multiple times myself, and just knowing, you know, what's the worst thing that can happen? And how about we develop a plan to mitigate that? I have a child that has like life-threatening allergies, and we wanted to go on a trip. And it was like, well, what if the worst case scenario happens? What if he eats something that causes, you know, anaphylactic shock? Well, we have an EpiPen, so we can administer the EpiPen. I can prepare ahead of time. I can find out where the hospitals are ahead of time so that in the likelihood of, you know, one of these allergic events, we know exactly where to go. We're not trying to look it up while we're in a state of crisis, right? So those are some of the scenarios where it actually benefited me personally. So I also use this when I'm considering, you know, taking courses, hiring a coach. I've hired multiple coaches, business coaches, life coaches, you know, therapist. I've done hypnotherapy. I'm a lot of work, y'all. But I sort of go through like, and it's so interesting whenever I try to break out through to the next level, it raises all these fears. And so this is a very pragmatic way of addressing those fears. So there's actually more to the worksheet. So page two of the worksheets is called Consider the Potential Benefits of Taking Action. So this is sort of more in line of like, oh, I was considering a business coach. And so I ran it through the, what are the potential benefits? Like for me, like what's the worst thing that could happen? Well, I'd be out that money. I wasted time, you know, nothing came of it. But what are the benefits of taking action, right? So write down the positive benefits or even an attempt or partial success at taking action. So I hire a business coach, they give me a great strategy, I execute on it, and it's financially successful or personal rewarding or both, right? Those are some of the positive benefits. Step number six, assess the potential positive benefit of these successes on a scale of 1 to 10. And this is an interesting exercise because then it allows me the potential to prioritize possible benefits. And it might even change where I spend my time and energy, right? So page number three, consider the consequences of inaction. So number seven of this whole process is make three columns on the page and label them 6 months, 1 year, and 3 years. Projecting out the past 3 years to feels too intangible, so keep it in this range. And so the worksheets actually have, you know, writing spaces so you can write all the stuff down. Number eight is write down the potential costs of maintaining the status quo. Consider emotional, financial, and physical costs. So like, what is it costing you to keep doing what you're doing? When I was considering all these projects that my business coach was suggesting, I was thinking, oh my God, this is going to take a lot of time and energy, and you know, it's going to cost me time away from my family. And what are the alternate activities that I could do to mitigate some of that, those costs? And what I decided was to outsource a bunch of stuff. And so that's what I have been doing. So that was actually super helpful. And then finally, what might be the benefits of an attempt or partial success? So the worksheet actually contains three pages, and the third page, it has plenty of room for you to sort of do those journaling exercises. So I just wanted to, you know, give you another tool, a worksheet. I love me a worksheet. There's something about writing that helps me just sort out my thought process. You know, I had a friend that tell me a long time ago that you have a BS filter in your elbow, and when you write, the truth comes out. And that has definitely been the truth for me. So anyway, I just want to share that with you. I hope this fear setting instructions worksheet is helpful to you. Definitely watch the Tim Ferriss TED Talk on how to mitigate your fears. And I think this has been, I've gotten so much feedback when I've shared this in my women's groups and in the classes that I teach, that this is a way to help manage and mitigate fear. It's going to come up for all of us, especially those of us who are really pushing to grow and evolve and change and reach our goals. You know, this life that we leave, there's no limit. The only limits that we have are in our own minds. So let's break through those negative limiting beliefs. This is a very practical, pragmatic tool that I think will help you. And if you try it, I would love to hear your comments. And there you have it. I hope that helps. And I will talk to you soon. Have a great day.